What we got here? V1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. What is that meaning? Next, see, in the words I am writing, the relative velocity approach before collision. That equal to what we can write? The relative velocity separation after collision. So what is that meaning? U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. Okay, this is the meaning in words. Okay, the relative velocity approaches before collision, the relative velocity separation after collision. This is the meaning of U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. Okay, now we are going to do that values. We are going to find the velocities. V1 value, V1 is equal to how much? Next, V2 is equal to how much? If we are able to find these values, then our velocity will be ended. So for this purpose, so what is the first one? See here, U1 minus U2 is equal to, can I write V1? Then what is this equal to? V, this is equal V2 is equal to. Okay, so already I said from the previous equation, what is that equation? We are having M1 U1 plus next M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Okay, so can I substitute here V2 value here simply? V2 value, what happened here? M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2. Okay, V2 how much is there? U1 minus U2 plus V1. So next, M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to how much is there? M1 V1 plus M2 U1 M2 U2 plus M2 V1. Okay, after writing this, simply we have to get the V1 value. So where is the V1? Here also V1 is there. Next, another, where is the V1? Here V1 is there. Send the remaining term this side. What happened here? M1 U1 plus M2 U2. Next, minus M2 U1 plus M2 U2. Then which term is common? V1 M1 plus V1 M2. Okay, now which terms here same thing is there? Here M1 U1, where is the M1 U1? Here also M1 M1 V1. Next, another M1 V1, where? Here M2. So what we have to take common? Actually we need the V1 value. Here V1 is there. Next, where is the V1? Next V1 here. Then bring this side. So what happened here? M2 U2. What happened here? M1 U1. Next, minus M2 U1 plus, how much is there? 2 M2 U2 is equal to how much is there? V1 M1 plus V1 M2. So can I take common here? M1, here how much is there? M1 is there. Here how much is there? Sorry, here M2 is there. Which one we can take common? This term we can take common. Next, here also we can take common this one. So here what we can take common? U2 we can take common. Here what we can take common? V1 V1 take common. So now I am writing the final equation. See, M1 minus M2, how much is there? U1 is there. Next, what is there? 2 M2 is there. How much is there? U2. This is which equal to? Can I take common V1? M1 plus M2. This is the equation. So from this, what we need? We need the value of V1.
V1, how I can write? Tell me. See, what is this here?
M1 minus M2 U1 plus 2M2 U2 is equal to how much is there? V1. And then again, how much is there? That is M1 plus M2. Next, this side, how much is there? M1 plus M2. Okay, this is the V1 velocity. What do you get finally? V1 is equal to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into U1 plus next 2M2 by M1 plus M2 U2. This is the V1 value. Next, now we are going to do the next one value. What is that value? Now we are going to find the V2 value. How we can find the V2 value? Same from the from this equations. What is that equation? Tell me. Now which value I need? Same. U1 minus U2 is equal to V2 minus V1. Okay. Previous, which value is which value I have taken? V2 I have taken. Now what I have to take? Now I have to take the V1 value. So what happened? U1 minus U2 minus V2 is equal to minus V1. Then if you take count, what happened? U2 plus V2 minus U1 is equal to V1. So where you have to substitute this U, V1 value? Same thing. The law of conservation of momentum. Where is the law of conservation of momentum equation? It is here. So wherever V1 is there, say here also, here V1 is there. Simply in this place you have to substitute. What is that? M1 U1 plus equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Okay, we are having V1 value. Simply substitute these values here. Okay, what happened? M1 U1 plus M2 U2. Next, M2 V2 plus how much is there? M1 into V1, how much is there? U2 plus V2 minus U1. Okay, next, what happened? M1 U1 M2 U2 M2 V2 plus M1 U2 next M1 V2 next M1 U1. Okay, previously which one I have to take common? V1. Now which one I have to take common? V2 I have to take common. Where is the V2? Here V2 is there, here also V2 is there. We have to take common the V2. Next M1 U1 M2 U2 next what happened? Minus M1 U2 plus M1 U1 then M2 V2 plus M1 V2. Okay, if any terms gets cancelled, check once 2 M1 U1, this is 1, again this is 1. Next here what is the next one? M2 minus M1. Which term we can take common? U2. What I mean here, which term here you can take common? Not this one, you can take common V2. M2 plus M1 V2. Okay, next, what I can write? Tell me next, 2 M1 by M1 plus M2 U1. Next, M2 minus M1 by U2 by M1 plus M2 is equal V2. Okay, see, what is the difference between road and this? So only this first term U1, in front of the U1 what is there? M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 is there, but here what is there? Some different terms will be there. This is the final velocity of the V2. Okay, now we got the V1 values and V2 values. After collision happen, they are reaching the velocities. How much velocities they have reached here?
V1 is equal to how much is there? Minus M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 U1 and M2 like that. Next, V2 is equal to how much is there? 2M1 U1 plus M1 plus M2. Okay. Okay. Which case we consider? This is one dimensional collision. Okay, their masses, here how much? M1 greater than M2. Okay, in case, same thing, in this one dimension collision only, in case, if the masses are equal, then what would happen? So, for that, we'll see. In case, M1 is equal to M2. M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M. Then what happens simply from that formula? Tell me. So, V1 is equal to. Anyway, first one automatically become 0. Next, what happened here? To M. Next, what happened here? To M. Next, what happened? U2. So, what happened total? 2m gets cancelled, v1 is equal to u2. This is the first case, v1 is equal to. Next, same thing you can apply in the v2 also. What happened here? V2 is equal to. Tell me, what happened here? 2m by 2m u1. Then that term automatically 0. What happened? This is v2 is equal to 2m gets cancelled. Next, u1. So, what is happening here? V1 is equal to U2 and next V2 is equal to U1. Okay, this is the 8 mass questions. Very, very important for the your examination. Okay, V1 value. Remember this value. Next, V2 value. Okay, this is for, this is valid. This V1 and V2 valid this, in this case. Okay, if case is like this. Case is like this, means second case is this is. Okay, M1, M2 is equal to M. Okay, if masses are equal, then what happen here? V1 is equal to U2 and V2 is equal to U1. Okay, if masses are not equal, means V1 is equal, will get this much and V2 is equal, will get the this much. Okay, in this way, the one dimension collision will happen. Okay, this is happening in elastic collision. The total phenomena is happening in the elastic collision. Okay, now, next topic is the inelastic collision. So, inelastic collision, what is the inelastic collision? Already I have given the definition initial only. Inelastic collision means only the conservation of law, momentum will be exist. The kinetic energy, the law of conservation of kinetic energy won't be exist. Inelastic collision or oblique collision. Okay, we will discuss that is in the next class. What is the oblique collision and what is the inelastic? Inelastic collision takes place in the oblique collision.